Google Calendar is a free app from Google that tracks your events, tasks, reminders, and goals. It is available on Android, iPadOS, and iOS, and it also has a web version you can access from any desktop. The app has a familiar feel across all platforms. It's easy to get started whichever device you pick up. Hello everyone, this is Uncle Dan, back with Paperless X. In today's video, we'll talk about Google Calendar across all platforms. Make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on your notifications so that you don't miss any of our videos. If you use multiple operating systems, Google Calendar is a great calendar app to add to your workflow. On the go, you can create events, tasks, and reminders on your iPhone, then access them on a bigger device like your Samsung Tab. Your plans sync across all your devices effortlessly. Google Calendar doubles as a task management app, allowing you to create tasks just like you would in Google Tasks. The two apps are seamlessly integrated, such that any to-dos you add to your Google Calendar automatically appear in Google Tasks and vice versa. On the web, you can easily access Google Tasks to manage your to-dos. You can add subtasks or create new lists. You can also see your completed to-dos at the bottom of your list. Google Calendar sets apart your to-dos from the events, reminders, and goals by displaying them with a Google Tasks logo. When you check off your to-dos, Google Calendar strikes them, which differentiates them from incomplete tasks. You can create a reminder in Google Calendar. Set a date, time, and choose the repeat for it. Your reminders have their own icon, making them easier to spot. When you mark a reminder is done, Google Calendar strikes it out. Reminders and tasks are very similar in that both are small, quick to-dos you check off as you complete them. They both have timestamps for Google Calendar to notify you of your due dates. With reminders, each time you complete a to-do, the app strikes it out and moves it to the date you completed it. This might help if you like tracking when you completed different tasks. A task can be more detailed with simple notes. On the web version, you can even add subtasks without going to Google Tasks. They also have different icons, which can help you tell them apart. You can only create goals on the mobile version of Google Calendar. Your goals can be exercise, build a skill, friends and family, etc. Your goals appear on the web version, and you can edit them from there. Hiding your events from the calendar also hides your goals. We hope Google will separate goals and events just like it does with reminders and tasks. On all your devices, you get the scheduled day, week, and month views. On the web app, you also get a year view. Clicking on a date displays its plans. What's more exciting is that you can edit all your plans right there. It would be better if you could create plans from this view. You can create custom views to personalize your experience in Google Calendar. These give you options to display a certain number of days or weeks on your calendar. On all your views, Google Calendar dims all your past events, which helps not to confuse them with upcoming ones. These customization options are only available on the web app and not on any mobile version. You can add your Google Calendar account on most calendar apps like Samsung Calendar, Apple Calendar, Microsoft Calendar, etc. You can access the app from almost any calendar app you prefer. It helps when you want to make use of unique features in different calendar apps. I like writing in Samsung Calendar, even on my Google Calendar events, which I tend to create in my Apple Calendar on the go. Google Calendar is a recycle bin on the web version. So even if you delete your events on the mobile version, you can restore them. Your events are permanently deleted after 30 days. The app only restores your events and goals though. We hope to also restore our tasks and reminders in the future. You can attach any files to your events. These files could be anything, videos, audio files, documents, and even zipped folders. We managed to add more than 10 files. On the web version, you can add multiple attachments at once. The only problem with attachments in Google Calendar is that you are limited to adding them from Google Drive only. You can't add files from your device and other cloud services. You can automatically add events from Gmail to your calendar. This could be flights, hotel and restaurant reservations, or events with tickets like movies and concerts. That is information I tend not to put into my Gmail. When you create an event from Gmail, you are simply taken to Google Calendar. It would be cool if we could create events without leaving Gmail. In Google Calendar, it said that we can only add attachments from Google Drive only. And also, we have limited options for events repeating yearly. Google Calendar is a user-friendly planning app that can track your day-to-day schedule across different platforms. You can better plan and manage your activities in one place. Please like this video if you found it helpful. Let us know what features in Google Calendar you like the most. Thanks for watching.